So behind you guys there, a couple of your farm team is planting the rice. And what is that machine?
It's a drum seeder, and it's just a way to kind of make manual rice planting a little bit more efficient.
In our area, people move from seeding the rice with seedlings to direct seeding. And so last year we had 10 people like basically walk and seed each portion. And then that just seemed like too much work. So we found this. This is like for the SRI rice technique. So it's built with specific spacing in mind. So it'll also space the rice correctly. And that makes like de-weeding really easy for us. If he does broadcast, it's really hard because then we don't use herbicides, so we can't kill the weeds. So then trying to select weeds while also stepping on seedlings is such a hard job. So this kind of organizes your seedlings into like a 30 by 30, so then you can walk and use a machine to de-weed. Our area, like almost all farmers grow rice, but they've been growing using such like bad techniques or with conventional techniques for really long. And their yields have been slowly, like very slowly increasing, but their chemical use has been like really skyrocketing because the land is just getting more degraded. But we wanted to do something in a different way. And so we were like, we can grow really good rice at better yields, but also, you know, use biological methods. So all of our rice is grown using biology. So we use compost extracts, we coat the seeds in biology, the full system. And yeah, we've been seeing better and better yields as we grow and using less and less inputs.
Yeah, we also use rice husk biochar as well. Biochar is a way of taking organic materials and organic waste and then burning it in a low oxygen condition in order to create a really carbon rich material that then you can put back into your land.
It kind of acts like a sponge. So it's not really a nutrient at all or anything, but it holds a lot of nutrients. So you can charge it with whatever kind of nutrients and biology you want, and it kind of stays in the air pockets between inside the biochar. And that's really great when you are starting with really, really poor soil. It really brings the nutrients back, but it also has a space to kind of hold the nutrients. Mm-hmm. So you really need that because, you know, here we're starting with like 0.2% organic matter. So like we're talking literally nothing left.
Wow. Yeah.
But like, we were able to get better yields than conventional in the first season. So this plot, we rented last season with 0.2% organic matter. We brought the biology back and we got higher yields at a lower cost. So you can kind of see, like with no pest issue, we had no pesticide, no herbicide, not even neem oil. The plants just, like they were like this big, like, it's pretty awesome.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Good job, guys.
That's so cool. It's so cool. It's just something about nature. She like really wants to come back, and like we kind of provide a small house for it, and boom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're gonna go check out how you make all this special biology, and maybe we can get some tips too for us like home growers.
Absolutely.
How can we incorporate some of these awesome techniques?
Yeah.
Man, that's really impressive. What do you use this rice for? Do you sell the rice, or is it seed, or what does it become?
A portion of it we grow kind of to sell as organic rice, but we're also starting to get really passionate about saving heirloom rice varieties in Thailand, but also within other Asian countries as well.
India and Thailand both have like hundreds of thousands of rice varieties that people used to grow. So like India itself, I think, had over 200,000 varieties of rice, and now there's like 8 that people grow. So
yeah,
and each one like was suited to kind of grow in a specific microclimate. So like, it would be very resistant to any drought, like heat tolerance, cold tolerance, but now like we have a lot more issues. And so like bringing some of these old varieties back will help us kind of also safeguard the long-term rice production.
Yeah, and we have people who work with us on the farm. They're a little bit older, but they remember when they were growing up, they had a different rice variety of seed that they no longer grow, but they remember that that particular variety required like no inputs, no synthetic fertilizer whatsoever, and their parents didn't have to use any type of pesticides to grow it, mm-hmm. or even like to input any synthetic fertilizer. So we don't want those varieties to go missing.
That's true.
So how does this guy do it? Like he's just dragging this thing.
Yeah, he's also not wearing shoes. Yeah. I think it's the most comfortable way to. Yeah, so there's just little holes in the drum. Uh-huh. And then as you drag it, the wheel spins and then the seeds just drop into the rice paddy. Yeah, and then it germinates within a week. And we also add a biological seed coating mix as well.
Before you put it
put it in the drum seeder. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We soak it one day and then we wait till it germinates a bit. So when it goes into the soil, it's already pre-germinated. And we want that because we want the biology to touch the root before it, like as it's touching in, so then it develops all of the biological as the root system grows. So yeah, if you want to take a look.
Oh, I need to peel.
If you look here, you can kind of see some of the seed coating with some compost and some other nutrients that we add.
And you can see that that's the root right
there,
right?
Yeah, that's the root.
Wow.
Yeah, so then they just fill it this in, and then there's little holes here. There's two settings. One has many more holes, then you cover it up with this little cloth thing. So it's easy. Low. It's only like $80, so it's quite efficient.